In my last video series 84, we discussed one of the methods of working capital assessment called maximum permissible bank finance. Today, with the help of this video series 85, let us understand the preparation and application of a statement called funds flow statement. We have discussed the stages involved in the process of credit appraisal. They are: 1. The bank has to be satisfied with the acceptability of the projected sales, because the projected sales is the starting point for deciding how much working capital finance need to be extended. The second one is to assess the required working capital finance. The starting point is the investment in the total current assets. So ensure that the proposed investment in the current asset is need-based to achieve the acceptable level of sales. The third one is, in any credit facility, the company need to bring in what is called as margin. When the company promises to bring in margin, as a banker, we need to ensure the source from where the margin for working capital is proposed to be brought in by the company. Unless we are satisfied as to the source of working capital, we may not process the request for credit facility. Now let us start with the funds flow statement. Funds flow statement talks about the reasons for the change in financial position of a company between two balance sheet. The financial position keeps on changing on a daily basis. Suppose a balance sheet is prepared as on 31/3/21 and another balance sheet is prepared as on 31/3/22. Between these two balance sheet, how the financial position has changed. It portrays the inflow and outflow of funds. How much funds have come in, how much fund has gone out. Or in other words, the sources of fund and the application of funds for a particular period. That is, between two balance sheet means between two financial years. The profit and loss account and balance sheet will give 2 years figures, that is the current years and the previous years, but it will not explain as to why the movement of fund has happened. Let us say, what is the extent of use of long-term funds for a long-term needs and the use of short-term funds for the long-term and short-term. Here is why fund flow statement is prepared. Say for example, we are aware that the long-term sources of funds are the term liability, the net worth. And the long-term uses of funds are fixed assets, non-current assets and intangible assets. Short-term sources of funds are current liability. Short-term uses of funds are current assets. So long-term sources of fund, how much is used for long-term uses of funds? How much is used for short-term uses of funds? Similarly, the short-term sources of fund, how much is used for short-term uses of fund and how much is used for long-term uses of funds? We know the sources of funds are classified into the fund brought in by the owners and outsiders. And outsiders again get divided into two, current liability and term liability. Current liability is what is to be paid to the outsiders within a period of 12 months, and term liability is what is to be paid to the outsiders beyond a period of 12 months. Now let us understand the application of funds. He talks about the how the funds are being utilized. How much fund is deployed in fixed assets, non-current assets, in current assets, intangible assets. Now let us understand the importance of the funds flow statement with respect to a banking industry. The most interested users of the fund flow statement are the lenders of working capital. They pay more attention to the fund flow statement than the profit and loss and balance sheet. Lending banks expect that the entire resources or the sources of fund, which come either from owners or from outsiders, are used in either in fixed assets or in current assets which are productive in nature. When working capital finance is provided by banks, it is expected that the company uses the working capital finance only for investment in current assets. When I say current assets, those assets which are part of the working capital cycle or operating cycle and which are convertible into cash in the next 12 months. The extent of company's investment in working capital and the short-term sources of funds available and the shortfall which need to be bridged can be ascertained from the funds flow statement. Similarly, whether the company had diverted the short-term source of fund for long-term uses such as an unproductive investment in capital market, group firms, subsidiary companies, etc. can be detected by preparing and analyzing a funds flow statement. The availability of margin for working capital and the sources of working capital can be ascertained from the funds flow statement. That is why whenever a bank considers a working capital finance to a company, they thoroughly scrutinize the funds flow statement to ensure that adequate fund will be available by way of margin to meet the working capital requirement and that there is no diversion of funds for unproductive purposes. Let us look at the certain questions answered by the funds flow statement. The first one is whether any fund has been generated from the operation of the business. If so, where the fund was utilized. That means, was there an operating profit? If there was an operating profit, how that operating profit had been utilized? Two, if there has been an increase in working capital, how has it been funded? Say for example, on 31/3/20, the total current asset was say 1000. On 31/3/21, the current asset increased to say 1250. How the increase of 250 had been funded? That is the question number two. Third, what may be the possible reasons for the decrease in net working capital despite an increase in profit earning? Suppose between two profit and loss account statement, you find that there is an increase in profit, but at the same time you find that the margin for working capital has declined. How it has happened? That is, networking capital, that is the margin for working capital, decreases when the profit increases. The fourth one, similarly, why is net working capital is increasing when profit earnings are deteriorating? There is a decline in profit, but still you find that the margin for working capital keeps on increasing. How is it possible? Number five, the most important thing, whether acquisition of additional capital assets, say for example a land and building or any machinery, has been funded entirely by means of a long-term sources, or if not, whether any short-term funds have been utilized for the purpose. It is expected that the short-term uses are funded by short-term sources plus margin, and long-term uses are funded by long-term sources. Now, let us understand first the format of the fund flow statement, and it is a very simple one to prepare. Generally, when I was in bank, I used to think that it's a tough job to prepare a fund flow statement. It is a very, very simple job. Let us learn the concept of preparing and understanding a funds flow statement. First, I will show you the format of the funds flow statement. Funds flow statement has got three parts. First of all, one is the long-term sources. Second one is the long-term uses. Then the third one is the increase in working capital gap. Now let us start with the long-term sources. It starts with the net profit, depreciation, any increase in capital, any increase in reserve, any increase in term liabilities, any decrease in gross block, any decrease in non-current asset, any decrease in intangible asset. That is between these 2 years. The sum total of that will give you the long-term sources of funds. Now let us understand the long-term uses again between two financial years. Instead of profit, suppose there was a loss, net loss, any increase in gross block, any increase in non-current assets, any increase in intangible assets, or any decrease in term liabilities, or any decrease in capital or reserve. The sum total of that will give you total uses of funds. If the long-term sources is greater than the long-term uses, there will be a surplus. That means we will come to the conclusion that there is margin available for working capital. On the other hand, some of the long-term uses are more than the long-term sources, there is a deficit, which indicates that there is no margin for working capital. Now let us go on to the third part of it. We like to find out the increase in the working capital between two periods. We know by MPBF method, working capital gap is equal to total current assets minus other current liabilities, that is current liabilities excluding bank borrowing. Similar is a case here. Between two balance sheets, I will look at what is the increase in current assets, or decrease in current assets as the case may be, or increase or decrease in other current liabilities excluding bank borrowing. The difference will give you an increase or decrease in working capital gap. Now, having found out the increase or decrease in working capital gap, we will find out the surplus of long-term sources over long-term uses, or the deficit between the long-term sources and long-term uses, that will be deducted from the increase or decrease in working capital gap. What I will be getting is a shortfall or surplus in working capital gap. Then if there is a shortfall, that would have been funded by the increase in the working capital finance. Had there been a surplus, naturally the working capital finance to that extent might have come down. So the figure ultimately after preparation should, the shortfall or the surplus should tally with the increase or decrease in bank borrowing for working capital. This is the simplest form of funds flow statement. Divide into three parts, find out the long-term sources. The second part, find out the long-term uses, find out either surplus or deficit. find out whether there is a increase in current assets or decrease in current assets. Find out whether there is an increase in other current liabilities or decrease in other current liabilities. Find out whether there is an increase or decrease in working capital gap. From the increase or decrease in working capital gap, deduct either the surplus or the deficit in long term sources over long term uses. There will be a shortfall or surplus. That shortfall, if it happens, to that extent the working capital finance should have gone up. If there was a surplus, to that extent the working capital finance might have come down. This is how the funds flow statement is prepared. Now let us understand with a small example, how do you say what is a source, what is a use? I am giving you three positions. The first position, the capital of a company is 200 and it has got a term loan of 300. So total long-term sources of that company is 500. Total long-term uses is fixed assets 350 and other assets. Let it be that current assets or any non-current assets, it was 150. So both sides tallied. It has got a long-term sources of 500 and a long-term uses of 500. Now you look at the position number two. When it goes to position number two, there is no increase in capital. Capital remains the same at 200, whereas the term loan increased by 100. That means the sources increased by 100. So we have now come to the conclusion that any increase in liability is a source. Now the company got an additional 100. What it has done with the 100? There is no change in fixed assets. 350 remains at 350. But the other assets increased from 150 to 250. So both sides of the balance sheet tallied, and any increase in asset is a use. Now the position number two teaches us that any increase in liability is a source of funds to the company, and any increase in asset is a use of funds for the company. Now you look at the position number three. Capital remains at 200, whereas the term loan which was 300 increased to 400, now has been brought back to 100. That means the company repaid 100 back to the bank. Now the lesson from this is any decrease in the liability is a use. Any increase is a source, any decrease is a use. Now look at what has happened. From where it got that 100, fixed assets remains at 350, again at 350, but now reduced to 250, which means the company sold fixed assets worth 100. That means any decrease in asset is a source. Now the learning is increase in liability is a source, whereas decrease in liability is a use. Increase in asset is a use, any decrease in asset is a source. This is the fundamental basic principles based on which the fund flow statement is prepared. Now, I will give you a numerical example, say 2017-2018 the liabilities and 2017-2018 the assets are given. Now you look at the first, the term liabilities and long term uses and the net worth. The surplus of the company which was 5 has increased to 10. That means the net profit has increased. I am writing down the net profit which has increased from 10 minus 5, 5. There is an increase in depreciation because there are some gross blocks added. So the depreciation has given me 5. So my cash accrual now is 10. Now go to the term liability. Term liability has increased from 40 to 60. Any increase in liability is a source. So I am writing down that 20 as a source. Net profit is a source. Depreciation is a source. Now increase in the term loan is also a source. Now capital, absolutely there is no change, but reserve has gone up by 5. So the increase in reserve is a source for me. So my reserve has become 5. So my total increase in long term sources is 35. Now if you go to the right side, the gross block has increased. You should not take the net block in the fund flow statement. The reason being, having taken depreciation on the source side, you should always take the gross block on the user side. The gross block increased from 60 to 70. So my use has increased to 10 and my non-current increased from 20 to 25. So naturally, increase in NCA is 5, making my total long-term users at 15. I have sources 35, users 15. That means there is a surplus of LTS over LTU, which is 20. Now I have found that there is a margin available for working capital. Now we will move on to the third part of it. Now when you look at the current assets, the stock increased by 30, debtors increased by 35. So increase in current asset is 35. You look at the OCL. Don't look at the cash credit or the working capital finance. Look at the OCL that increased by 5 from 11 to 16. So the my working capital between 2 years increased by 30. That is 35 minus 5. Now I had a surplus of 20 by way of long-term sources over long-term users that I am deducting. My shortfall is 10. That 10 is funded by increase in working capital finance, because my working capital finance increased from 24 to 34. We will look at one more numerical, because I would like to tell you that it is a very, very simple method, and the preparation of work fund flow statement and the analyzing is not at all a complex process as many of us think. Here again the same thing. First we will prepare the LTS, how much is the long term sources, how much is the long term users. Then we will go to the working capital gap and the shortfall deficit, etc. Here if you look at, my net profit is 5, my depreciation increase is 10. Now the term loan has not increased, so it is not a source, it is a use. So let us not take that into account right now. But my unsecured loan has increased from 30 to 45. That means 15, there is a source. There is no change in capital, but the reserve has gone up from 10 to 20. So there is a source of 10. Now coming to the gross block decreased from 240 to 230. Any decrease in asset is a source. So the decrease in gross block, 10 is a source for me. So sum total of my long-term sources is 50. Now I am going to the long-term users. When I go to the long-term users, there is a decrease in the term loan. That is, it has decreased by 150 to 135. Any decrease is a use. So decrease in term loan gave me a use of 15. And there is an increase in investment. 20 plus 10, 30, 10. And intangible asset, absolutely there is no change. My total LTU has now become 25, giving me a surplus of 25. Here the concept is, the decrease in liability is a use and decrease in asset is a source. That is a concept that works out in this numerical example. Now let us move on. The current asset has increased by 100, say for example 120, 140, 200. 180, it became 300. So naturally the current asset increased by 100, whether the OCL increased by 10, giving me an increase in working capital gap of 90. I had a surplus of 25. I am deducting that. I get 65 shortfall, and that 65 is funded by the increase in the working capital finance by way of cash credit account. This is the way in which any fund flow statement is prepared. Now let us just discuss a fund flow statement from a audited balance sheet of a company. It is between a company 2020-2021, 2021-2022 and the balance sheet of 2022-2023. If you look at here in the 2020-21, the surplus came from the long LTS. If you look at that, 60.64 crores. There is a great inflow of long-term sources by way of net profit. There is a reserve has gone up. The depreciation is 11 crore. The deposits have gone up, term deposits. And there is a term loan, there is an increase of 2.89. And pertinently, the trade deposit, the increase is 29.90 crore, making the 60.64 crore. During that year, the company went in for an expansion, made a lot of investment in the gross block, and the gross block investment amounted to 43.06 crore, leaving a surplus of 17.58 crore. During that period, the working capital gap increase was 19 crore, and 17.58 crore, the surplus is deducted, leaving a shortfall of 1.42 crore, and that shortfall was funded by the working capital finance. Similarly, if you look at in the 2021-22, there is only net profit of 14.719 crore, and there was a term deposit amount slightly increased, and the depreciation contributed. The total LTS was 24.03 crore, and the utilization, if you look at, a part of the trade deposit has been paid off to the extent of 1.95, and the company had repaid a part of the term loan to the extent of 8.02 crore, and there is a marginal increase in the non-current assets. That means if you look at, compare the surplus of LTS over LTU between 20 and 21, and comparing that with the 21 and 22, you will see that there is a decline in margin. There is a margin, but at the same time, there is a decline in that. So here there was a shortfall of 69 crore, which was funded by the working capital finance extended by the bank. When it comes to the production, that is 2022-2023, there again, the only contributor is net profit, that is estimated net profit, and the term deposit and the depreciation, making the total LTS to 30.34 crore. And surprisingly, the company keeps on reducing the trade deposit term loan, and there is an increase in non-current asset, making the total LTU to 20.24 crore. And the surplus, even when comparing with the previous two balance sheet, is found to be less by almost 3 crore. And current asset keep on decreasing in this case. And there is an increase in OCL. As a result, there is a working capital gap. But that, though the working capital gap has increased compared to the previous year, the increase in working capital gap is less. So when you compare 21 and 22, the increase in working capital was 82 crores. Whereas when it comes to a comparison of the projection between 22 and 23, the increase in working capital is 36.29 crore. As a result, the shortfall reduced to 26.19 crore, which is funded by way of banks' working capital finance. This is how the fund flow statement is prepared. So, by this video series 85, we have learned the fund flow statement. We have understood the preparation of fund flow statement and its application in banking industry. Unless you start doing it practically, taking one or two companies' balance sheets and start preparing it, you will not understand how simple it is to prepare a fund flow statement. And subscribe to this channel to receive intimation on my new videos. Please note that the subscribing to this channel is free. Press the like button and share the information with your friends. In my next video series 86, I shall come up with another interesting topic on lending. Thank you all very much. I hope you have enjoyed the session.